Good day, grade 11 students. This is our last lesson for Practical Research 1 for this week. But before we start with our lesson, let us have first a prayer.
In the name of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Once again, good day, grade 11 students. How are you today? I hope that you are ready to learn our last lesson for Practical Research 1. For this lesson, we will discuss about strengths and limitations of qualitative research. For this lesson, you are going to describe characteristics, strengths, weaknesses, and kinds of qualitative research. What are the strengths of a qualitative research? You need to know the strengths of the qualitative research as well as the weaknesses so that when you are doing the research process, you will know where you should focus and para malaman ninyo kung ano nga ba yung maaaring maging limitations or gaps na gagawin yung research. Number one, issues can be examined in detail and in depth kasi nga lahat itatake cover holistic yung approach. Interviews are not restricted to specific questions and can be guided or redirected by the researcher in real time. So, di ba nga, hindi tayo nagsasurvey dito, hindi lang tayo nagpapasagot ng questionnaires kasi meron tayong mga interviews or observations dito sa qualitative research. Pwede tayo magkaroon ng mga additional questions kung gusto pa natin ng additional data. Third, the research framework and direction can be quickly revised as new information emerges. Okay? Or, the obtained data based on human experience is powerful and sometimes more compelling than quantitative data. So, di ba, kunwari kapag nakikipaghuntahan or nakikipagchismisan ang mga kapitbahayan, ay talaga namang mas gusto nila yung talagang pinapalawig yung usapan dahil mas marami silang masasabi. Kapag parang ganyan lang din sa qualitative, mas ma-express mo yung data kaysa sa data na numerals sa qualitative kasi mas parang naikukwento mo yung nangyayari. 5. Subtleties and complexities about the research subjects and or topic are discovered that are more often missed by positivistic inquiries. So dito, makikita mo talaga yung mga in-depth analysis ng mga realities. Diba? Yung mga documentaries, case studies, unlike sa mga positivistic inquiries na parang andun lang, nakalimit lang sa mga ganong studies. 6th, is data are collected from a few cases or individuals, so findings can be generalized to a larger population. Findings can, however, be transferable to another setting. So dito naman, di ba, nakafocus na sa ilang individual, komunidad, sa komunidad, unlike sa quantitative data na kailangan malaking populasyon yung makuhanan mo ng data. How about for limitations? Research quality is heavily dependent on individual skills of the researcher and more easily influenced by researcher's personal biases and idiosyncrasies. So, masyado kasing involved yung researcher dito sa proseso, so pwedeng mailagay niya yung sarili niya doon sa research. Rigor is more difficult to maintain, assess, and demonstrate dahil nga napakadaming kailangang i-analyze or pag-aralan. The volume of data makes analysis interpretation time-consuming. It is sometimes not as well understood and accepted quantitative research within the scientific community. So, syempre, dinidiscuss lang yun na walang findings, direct evidence, direct numbers, direct data, observations lang, interview, analysis of what you are observing. So, minsan, unquantified or hindi masyadong unfounded yung observations or yung resulta na nakukuha. 5th, the researcher's presence during data gathering, which is often unavoidable in qualitative research, can affect subjects' responses. So, syempre, kung nandun yung researcher, for example, ang ini-study niya ay isang individual na may ganitong uri ng sakit, minsan nag-iiba sila ng mood or attitude. So, hindi talaga nakukuha yung dapat na ma-observe. O kaya naman, sa documentaries, minsan nahihiya yung iba na ipakita yung natural nilang ginagawa. O kaya naman, nagiging conscious sila. So, imbis na ganito ipakita, parang iba na yung naipapakita nila. 6. Issues of anonymity and confidentiality can bring result to problems when presenting findings. So, syempre, minsan, nangyari sa subject A, ganito, ganito, dinescribe mo kung ano yung abilities niya o yung attitudes niya. Baka kasi may kakilala silang ganun. So medyo nawawala na yung anonymity ng participants. 7. Findings can be more difficult and time-consuming to characterize in a visual way. Okay, so that's it for our lesson number 3, the strengths and limitations of a qualitative research. If you want to learn more about this lesson, you can open the file on your flash drive about this topic. It's time for you to answer the assessment sheets, answer activity 4 on this part. I am leaving you with this Bible verse for this week. This is what God asks you, only this, that you act justly, that you love tenderly, that you walk humbly with your God. Coming from Micah 6 verse 8. Thank you for listening for this week's videos. Thank you for this resource, for giving me the enough material to teach you about this. Once again, I am Mr. Rolly C. Franco. See you again next week for another lessons for qualitative research. Our practical research one. Thank you. Happy learning, grade 11 students.